Hello everyone, welcome back to IT Samurai Teacher. My name is Sheikh Abdul. Today I'm going to show you another free tool. It's called Dataplicity. It's a web-based tool that lets you control your Raspberry Pi remotely from anywhere in the world, any web browser. So what is Dataplicity? Dataplicity is a web-based application that allows you to securely access and control your Raspberry Pi from any browser. This means that you can check on your Pi status, view its files, and even run commands, all without having to be physically present at the location of the Raspberry Pi. So why you use Dataplicity? There's so many reasons why you might want to use Dataplicity to control your Raspberry Pi remotely. First of all, it's free. Okay, one node is free. So some example, access your Pi from work or school, check on your Raspberry Pi status while you're on vacation, or run commands on your Pi from a different computer, or share your Pi with others. If you want to troubleshoot, just create this account and send this link. Everyone can log in and troubleshoot your Raspberry Pi behalf of you. So how does Dataplicity work? Dataplicity works by creating a secure tunnel between your web browser and your Raspberry Pi. This tunnel is encrypted, so your data is safe from prying eyes. So how you getting started with Dataplicity? It's very easy. Getting started, all you need is a Raspberry Pi. You can use 4, 5, 3, any version, any model, and an internet connection and web browser. First, you need to install Dataplicity on your Raspberry Pi. You can do this by following the instruction on the Dataplicity website. I'm also going to show you step by step in a bit. And another one is, once the Dataplicity installed, you need to create an account and configure settings, and then you can access your Raspberry Pi from any web browser anywhere in the world by visiting the Dataplicity website and login to your account. There's a features like secure web-based access, file browsing and transfer, command line access, data desktop sharing, real-time monitoring, everything. So let's jump in and let's do the demonstration. Okay, first of all, what you need to do is just type dataplicity.com. Just make sure you go to the correct website. If you don't sure, just click this and make sure connection is secure. If it looks good, if you want to check the certificate, click the certificate and make sure you have the correct certificate. You can get bunch of details here. So once you correctly identify this is the correct website, okay, don't worry. So if you type this correctly, it should be fine. Just in case, you always can check your certificate. So once you're in here, there's a bunch of information in here. Oops, go back so you can see the bunch of information. So they're saying that, hey, they are stranger, enter your email above and line of the code will appear here. So, you know, let's do this and see what happened. So once you enter your email address, I'm going to say it, you know what, I think I have a test one. I'm going to use a test one somewhere to use it, and I'm going to click start. So once you click that, I mean, if you want, you can sign up first and after that you'll get the code, but you'll get the same thing. So you will get email. Okay, make sure you have access to your email address, and after that they will give you a script to run on your Raspberry Pi. I'm going to copy this and I'm going to paste my Raspberry Pi. I'm going to run it. Before that, just in case, if you are curious about what this code does or do, just click this view source and you will see all the Python code is running in here. A bunch of stuff. Okay, so this code, This script automates the entire process of setting up a device with the Dataplicity agent, from downloading and installing the agent to configuring the system settings and reporting the installation status. It's designed to be robust, handling various system configuration and Python versions, and provides detailed logging and user feedback through the process. I'm going to close this and I'm going to copy this and I'm going to jump into my Raspberry Pi. I'm in my Raspberry Pi 4. It also tests on my Raspberry Pi 5. Works great. So I'm going to test this on my Raspberry Pi 4. I'm going to type enter. Now it's going to, you can see their logo, Dataplicity version 0.5.11. Welcome to the Dataplicity agent installer. Step 104, downloading open source agent, registering the device, configuring the system, starting the agent. Very cool. Dataplicity agent is now installed. Your device will be online in few seconds. Visiting the following URL to manage your device. Do you need any help? You can go to the docs. I'm going to copy this one. Now this is going to be, this our machine is now live on the internet. So I'm going to copy this. Don't worry, because you need to, no one going to log into this system yet, because you need to verify your email address and create a password. Then you're able to log into the system. Everything is free. Don't worry. Now let's jump into the website. Okay, now I paste it, and when I surf, I get a user, enter your email address and password. First, once you enter your email address in the first page, before we run that code, after it will send you email. So check your email, and after that they will send you a confirmation email. Click that confirmation email. After that, they will tell you to create a password. After that, you come here and sign in. This one, I already activate the two-factor authentication to make sure that my Raspberry Pi is in safe hands, because I don't want to someone jump into my Raspberry Pi connect. So this is very crucial. I'm not going to use my mobile phone, so I'm going to skip that for this demonstration purposes. It's going to app settings, that's fine. I'm going to copy, paste that. Oh, you know, it came. So yeah, look at that. So if you're in a login stage, just copy and paste, you blah, you jump into your Raspberry Pi. That's very cool. So what you need to do here is, just in case if you don't know, just type your and see your IP address. Cool, you can see your IP address and stuff. You can say please verify your phone number. I mean, it's good to verify your phone. So if you have a two-factor authentication, more security. So what I'm going to do here is, if you go to the main page, you can see in device list in here. So what I'm going to show you, that two-factor authentication, that if you want to change your password, you can change your password here. Authorization, you can see I enable the two-factor authentication, so I get a code, so I can enter. So I make sure that I am the only one who log into my Raspberry Pi. So that's also cool. So go to the settings and authorization, enable your two-factor authentication. Now this is for this one is free for one device, right? So I have, if you want more devices, I think it's very cheap, $3 or something per month. So in here, edit, you can a device name, change your device name. So you can have a bunch of Raspberry Pi devices. It's very good if you're running a lot of Raspberry Pi devices and you want to able to connect from anywhere in the world. If you put into your home and connect remotely. So if you connect, you can see, just click a button, you will connect. I'm going to show you something. So now in here, you cannot run sudo updates because you need to change back to your user. So if you know your user, my username is PI4. After that, I'm going to enter my password. Right. I'm able to jump into my account. Now I'm going to type sudo. So you can see, you can run updates. You can do anything you want in remotely. So if you think that you are very concerned, you're on vacation for a long period of time and you see that there's a new update came and you need to install and your Raspberry Pi are running on your school, work or home, and you want to connect to the machine and you want to run the updates, it's very easy. Connect to your log into your Dataplicity website and you have all your Raspberry Pi remotely connect and you can run any commands you want. This is a nice feature. So you can see you can make sure you enable your two-factor authentication. After that, you're in a good safe hand. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and give me a thumbs up. And if you have any question, please comment in my YouTube comment section. And I will see you on my next project. Thank you. See you soon.